Hello, Aquarius. I am Ulrich. I'm a lunar monk card reader. And today we will do the financial card reading. We'll be using a financial deck for your card reading for the month of February. As always, we will do four card readings for the sign of Aquarius for the month of February. And these are based on the natural elements in your astrological chart, or for some of you, on your time of birth. These basic elements are air, earth, water, and fire. Now, the four objects that you always see on my table are directly connected to those elements. So you choose or you pick one that you think relates most to your personality, or you choose one you feel most comfortable with. This object of your choice, it should or it will relate the best to your current situation. However, if the object and the related video does not match your first choice, please check the other videos that are immediately connected in the same session. I'm sure one of the four will fit you. Anyway, the matches represent the fire element, the stone represents the earth element, the aerosol sprayer represents the air element, and the shell represents the water element. So Aquarius, here we go for your card reading for February. Also, I want to add, if you have questions, you can always post them in the comments below. And as soon as I have time, of course, I will answer them. So Aquarius, here we go. Hello, Aquarius, and welcome to the Shell or the Water Group for your financial philosophical reading for the month of February. As the first card here, we see the card of time. It tells us here that time is not our friend if it comes related to money, meaning here, if we have certain debts, certain payments that we need to make here, and we wait with these payments here, we are realizing, of course, that we will pay interest or there will be certain consequences here. It means that our debts will increase if we don't start paying back here. We cannot also ignore the problem. We cannot put our head in the sand here because it will not improve our overall situation. Anyway, here, this card tells us that we need to take charge of our situation today. Don't wait until the holidays for making certain starts of repayments here, because if you do, it will only make your situation worsen. Anyway, there is no such thing as a perfect time for starting making a plan. We need to start acting now here. We need to make ourselves more financially secure, and probably this is connected to a radical change of habits. Maybe there are certain habits that you have that need to be drastically adjusted here. Here we are asked also to, if we don't have an overview, to take a piece of paper, a pencil, and analyze our situation. We write everything down here, and we see here in what categories we make categories of importance. And if you see that there are certain categories where you overspent, then you can recognize your problem there. Here it's important to do so. Here with this card, it tells us that's important to take the reins of our budget and rush towards more sustainability here. We do this one step at a time, but it's important that you stay with it, start with it today. The next card that we are seeing here, it's about the value of small coins, small bills, small amounts of money that we are spending here. And here we see that, like most of us, we pay very little attention to small amounts that we are spending, maybe cash, maybe with the credit cards here, but sometimes it can have a severe effect here on our payments. We see that a lot of people here, in this group maybe, it has a certain impact on their budget. Maybe they spend always small amounts of money and they think it has no impact, but actually this card tells us it is. Even if an expense is only small, you should think about it here. You should give it your sincere attention and especially take a critical look at certain small invoices, certain small payments that we are making here. Also, discounted items here, we should avoid. This is what this card is about. We should avoid buying things actually that are not necessary. If we always buy things, it blurs our financial clarity. This is what we are seeing here. We are aware here that it takes a lot of coins or bills to create 100 and then forging these hundreds into 1,000. This card tells us that each coin that you have now is of great importance. So the next time if you visit a store, before you actually put everything in front of the cashier, rate what you have bought. Look at the articles that you are about to purchase and reflect on the necessity of it. And the question is then here, you can re-evaluate these small amounts, these luxury purchases that no longer are necessary. They are not necessary because here we see there is some overspending on things that are not really essential. And sometimes we lose track if we always buy small things. So here we are asked to give these small amounts, these little coins, small bills, let it have its moment of glory. And by doing so, you will be able to save money. The last card is actually a quite strict card that we are having here. This is the card that asks you if you're living beyond your means. Here we see that probably we spend certain amounts of money. Maybe you spend money that you don't have, and maybe this is money that is on credit cards. This card tells us it's a warning, and it tells us if we don't adjust certain spendings in our life, maybe we could have hit the wall with our head here. Maybe we have certain debts here and these debts deepen. So here we need to realize here that we need to be able to pay it back by the end of the month. And if we are not able to do so, sometimes we get serious fees, interest fees mostly here. And of course, if we don't pay back these fees and the amount, they amount up to more losses and more expenses. So eventually we come in a certain circle, and we should try to get out of this circle of getting into debts or dues here. Here we need to see that if we amount certain debts, it has no value for us. Here we need to see that we are urged here to pay the things that we buy cash, but we should try to avoid paying with credit cards, because these credit cards, they have serious amounts of interest here, and you should be aware of this here. Also, if you have reoccurred so-called unexpected expenses, and if they come back every month, you know there is something wrong here. And here we are asked to reflect wisely, and if we really live beyond our means. So here we are asked to reevaluate ourselves, evaluate the use of our credit cards, and we are asked to take a serious reflection here if we are using our money wisely. So Aquarius, this is all for the Shell or the Water group. I hope you get a little bit wiser out of this strict card reading. I'm only the card reader. If you did, please subscribe to my channel. If this card reading don't fit you at all, please check the other three that are immediately connected here. I'm sure one of the four will fit you. Anyway, Aquarius, I want to thank you for your time, and I'm sure we see each other in my other videos. Thank you, Aquarius, and see you next time. Hello, Aquarius, and welcome to the Shell, the Stone or the Earth group for your card reading. Philosophical financial card reading. As the first card here, this is a more heavy card reading that we are having here. As the first card here, we see the card of severe financial problems, or for some bankruptcy. Sometimes this points that our financial situation is tormenting us. Maybe we don't sleep well anymore. We think about money. Maybe we have certain deficits. Maybe we have reached a point of no return here. Anyway, we should consider certain options. If your situation is really severe, we could be referred to a bankruptcy specialist. But of course, if you have your own business, but of course, before you start and especially sign certain agreements, you should inform yourself well and consult more than a professional here. You should evaluate certain choices that are offered for you, advantages, disadvantages here. And you should, of course, understand very well the impact that is going to have of this process on your present and on your future. Here we see that we need to be aware that these decisions, they have consequences, and probably you will need to change certain lifestyle, your lifestyle radically. Also your consumption habits, they will be affected here. In another way, if you did not reach that point, this is then we will first talk about the independent. And if you are, for instance, a private person and you are in a severe difficult situation, you could consider going in your local community, ask for a social assistant who is specialized in financial matters, and maybe this person can help you for figuring certain things out here. This is what we see here also in this card. Anyway, if you did not reach this point here, this means anyway that your financial situation is serious here. You still probably have financial worries, and probably it asks your immediate attention here. You need to adjust certain behaviors, because if you don't, probably you are about to hit the wall. Here, if this card ends up here for this group, we need to think seriously about our financial situation. The next card is also a heavy card, so it's related to the other one here. It points that we have probably accumulated certain debts on credit cards. And here we are asked to develop a certain strategy. Again, as I said in the first card here, it's a little bit the same. We should not be discouraged about our situation. It's by small steps, by small amounts paying back, that we get back on our feet. Here we are urged not to be discouraged before we start here. We should make a list of our loans, write down the respective rates, establish priorities here. And if you have certain credit cards that are sharking you, because probably this is the credit card that always gives you money, even though it's already very low below zero, we should get rid of those cards first. You should establish them out. That's the first priority, because some credit cards are really sharking and you should get rid of these first. Try to put some cash money in there and try to get rid of them once and for all here. Anyway, here we see if we are in debt mode here, we especially must stop spending money here. We need to take charge of our financial situation, and we should pull ourselves together the best we can here. Once we have reduced these debts, we will be able to have a less restrictive lifestyle. So, but here we see that we need to take action. The last card is that we need to probably be creative with the money that we have left. We live in a world where we can buy everything, and here we are asked to handle our money in a creative way. If you have certain presents that you need to give, maybe there's a birthday coming up, a holiday coming up, and you don't want to go empty-handed here, instead of buying something expensive, probably you can design something here in a few minutes. For instance, if you need to buy a storage box, instead of buying the storage box, you can probably make it with some recycled materials. Also, it saves you the hassle that you need to shop around for several hours and spend a small fortune about this dream box here. For instance, if your son's birthday is around the corner, or a niece, her birthday is coming up, with a little bit inventiveness, we could prepare a party here. We could make the pies, the cakes ourselves here, and we could still have a lot of fun ourselves here without settling ourselves for an astronomical bill. Here we are urged to be creative with the small amounts of money that we have left. Here we are asked, it's very good related here to this card, to be original and creative with the money that we have left. We need to start thinking out of the box for repayment, but also creative acting with our money. So take some time here to question your creativity, think what you can do with the money that you have left, and in what way you can be creative with the money that you have there. So here we are asked to make room for our imaginative spirit in the kitchen, in your work, in the management of your money, and towards your family. So this is all for this group. I hope you get a little bit wiser out of it, Aquarius. If you did, please subscribe to my channel. If this card reading don't fit you at all, please check the other three that are immediately connected here. I'm sure one of the four will fit you. Anyway, Aquarius, I want to thank you for your time, and I'm sure we see each other in the other videos. And of course, don't forget to subscribe, and I thank you for doing so. See you next time, Aquarius. Bye-bye for now. Hello, Aquarius, and welcome to the Air Group for your card reading, for your financial philosophical card reading. As the first card here, we see the card of our children. What does this card tell us? Well, it tells us that children are a beautiful wealth, but we also are aware that they are expensive. The apple of our eye, it costs us dearly. And as with any budget item, if I may put it that way, there are essential expenses for them and less essential expenses here. Sometimes Sometimes it means that requests come from all sides and we lose track, we lose our head here. And we should ask ourselves the benefits here of these costs incurred. We are asked here if we don't invest in the wrong things. Are you investing in their education, in their culture, in their health? Sometimes also this is that we are about following the flow of other parents. We follow certain trends of the moment, and this card tells us not to do so. It tells us to establish your own priorities according to your own values. Don't follow the trends. Also, don't follow the tears of your children. If you would be in a financial situation, we should not tell ourselves stories here, because we know that children have no limits as it comes to their desires. They will not stop. And as soon as they receive what you have requested them, probably they will buy. They will ask you for something new here. So stop wasting your energy in that. This card tells us you can be sure if you are in a certain difficult situation, that young people understand when you say no. Anyway, we should teach them here important lessons about setting priorities in certain conditions. The next card that we are seeing here is actually a rather harsh card. It's the card of bankruptcy or severe financial difficulties. Probably you're thinking about your financial situation. Maybe it keeps you up at night. You cannot sleep. You think about worry. Maybe there are certain deficits. For some people, it means if they have a business, for instance, they have reached a point of no return. If this is like an employee, it could mean that you have spent too much and that you are in severe financial difficulties. For the self-employed, it means maybe that they need to consider a bankruptcy specialist. But before you do so, before you sign certain agreements here, we should inform ourselves wisely and consult more than a professional. You should evaluate certain choices offered, the advantages, the disadvantages here, and we should understand very well here the impact of this process that it's going to have on your present and on your future. Here, we need to be aware that these decisions, they have consequences, and probably you need to change your lifestyle and your consumption habits radically. If you are lucky and you did not reach that point, also I want to add here for private persons, for instance, what they can do is they go to a social assistant of the community. Mostly these people help you for free, and you can ask some advice and maybe they can help you out for certain debts. Anyway, if you did not reach that point, and there are still some financial worries here, we should take an immediate modification of certain consumption habits, certain consumption behaviors here, because if you're not, it's possible here that we hit our head against the wall here. If this card is in your hands, it means that your situation is about to become serious, or it is serious. The last card that we have here is the card of love. It means that the people close to you, your children love you, the people around you, your friends love you, you are well liked here. This is what we are seeing here. But sometimes it points also that for showing our affection, we are spoiling them with presents. If we are in a severe financial situation, we should not do so. Here we are urged not to spend money on gifts, go out to dinner. Here, it's wisely here to be wise with your money. Here, rather than shopping around in malls and how to please your loved ones here, we should take a different approach. Also, we should be aware that love cannot be bought. Actually, you can give them a gift that is actually the most expensive of all. And this most expensive gift is time. Here we are asked to take some time out in private with the people that we love, in time private. Show your interest to your loved ones with valuing them with your time, but not with money or expenses. We should be aware, and we know that the best memories that we will carry later on with us are those related to stupid anecdotes, to funny occasions here, and it's not coming from object, toys, presents here. So here this card tells you to be gentle with yourself and see the positive effect that you will have, and you will come closer to your loved ones here, and it will not come from an object, a toy, or whatever it is that you think you need to buy. Anyway, it will have a positive impact on your relationship with these people around you, and also financially, it will be beneficial for you. So Aquarius, this is all for the air group. I hope you got a little bit wiser out of this short card reading. If you did, please subscribe to my channel. If this card reading don't fit you at all, please check the other three that are connected here. I'm sure one of the four will fit you. Anyway, Aquarius, I want to thank you for your time. And of course, don't forget to subscribe. And I thank you for doing so. See you next time, Aquarius. Bye-bye for now. Hello, Aquarius, and welcome to the Matches or the Fire group for your short philosophical financial card reading for February. As we see here as your first card, this is the card of recompensation or awards that we give to ourselves. We work hard, and sometimes we want to buy something for ourselves. But here, this card tells us to financially reduce certain rewards for us. We can do this, for instance, rewarding ourselves with simple means. For instance, if you on regular basis take a walk in the outside and it's very cold outside, we come home and we can make ourselves a glass of warm milk with some honey, or you live in a very hot area, you can make a glass of iced tea with a lot of ice cubes here, and these are very satisfying rewards and they don't cost much here. Anyway, we also need to think that we probably have done a lot of efforts in the last months for getting where we are. And here we should not forget the efforts that we did here. Even though we want to reward ourselves and it's normal and it's a normal practice here, we should not overdo it. You should not waste any efforts because probably you have come far. So, of course, we deserve certain rewards here, but if you think about it wisely and you take some distance here, you could also offer yourself some presents, things that don't cost much. For instance, you take a walk, you read, you listen to music, you do anything that don't cost money. It's very advisable if this card is here that we do so. Even if it is an idleness activity, or you go jogging here. So here we are asked to make a list what makes us tick, what is interesting us, and find rewards that don't cost money. Anyway, if you think for a while, you will find rewards that encourage you without financially breaking you or costing you a lot of money. The next card is that we are probably like to chase discounted items. This is what this card is about. We check out the sections of liquidations in hope to find the beautiful object, the pair of shoes, the electronic gadgets that we always wanted, or maybe some other thing that we don't actually directly need. These sometimes are small amounts, but they could have a serious importance on the long run. Anyway, we should also understand if we buy discounted items, we absolutely need to be sure that also we get a good deal, because some people, some businessmen are very smart and they adjust the price and then after they give you a discount. So be aware that these practices also happen. Anyway, this card tells us we should not be overwhelmed, not bewitched by sales, by discounts. We should keep our head very cool here and ask ourselves questions. Even if the price is reasonable, the question here, the big question is, do you need these things? Do you need these discounted things? Mostly when we always looking for these discounted items, we spend a lot more than we anticipated. And the question is it really necessary? So also this is about bulk buying. A lot of people for getting a better price, they buy in bulk. And here, we need to see that this is really bulk buying, because if you buy certain things in bulk, for instance, food, and you catch yourself at the end of the month or the week, or you give it to your neighbors or to your sister or to your brothers, it's not that you cannot be generous, but bulk buying is not about that. If you buy in bulk, you need to see that you can consume it. Of course, if you want to be generous to your sister or your brother, you can, but this is a different concept. Here we see if we buy in bulk, we should see that this is really economizing. So don't overflow your house with items that that only will accumulate. And also if we buy things discounted, sometimes we catch ourselves, bring it to recycling. So ignore the offered discounts, liquidations here, and think wisely about bulk buying. If you do so, your wallet will improve. The last card here that we are seeing here is the card about inheritances, in heritages. Sometimes also this card is about certain groups of people. They rely on the future. They have faith in the future. And maybe you think, or this group thinks, that it's unnecessary to accumulate certain savings for retirement. Maybe you are expecting some monies from an inheritance, from some relatives here, but be careful if you make this calculation. It's dangerous here to calculate on inheritance or money of other people, especially if this is a priority for your budget of an older age. If your parents are already unfit, also we have the fact that we have not read their will, and therefore we are never sure that we are their sole heir. We only know this when we are in the notary or in the lawyer, when the lawyer or the notary, they read the will. Also, we need to add here that life expectancy, it has exploded over the past decades, and our parents, and so will we will live much longer than our ancestors. And as we get older, we need gradually more things and our savings for paying for services for our survival conditions. You need the same, and your parents also. So nobody can blame us if we get older. Then we need to secondly add here that every person, including your parents, has the right to change their testamentary or the dispositions at any time. And we never know if our mother or father, they will not succumb to the young Venus living next door, or Cupid they met on the internet here. So we should be careful here, and they don't decide to favor this person for a part at the expenses of the descendants. We need to be very careful with this here. Anyway, an inheritance, it can be part of certain investments, but we need to be careful with doing so. Anyway, plan your old days or your investments independently, and this card tells us if you do so, you will come out as a winner. So Aquarius, this is all for the fire group. I hope you get a little bit wiser out of this short philosophical card reading. If you did, please subscribe to my channel. If this card reading don't fit you at all, please check the other three that are connected here. I'm sure one of the four will fit you. Anyway, Aquarius, I want to thank you for your time. And of course, don't forget to subscribe. And I thank you for doing so. See you next time, Aquarius. Bye-bye for now.